Welcome you students in Gurukul English Medium School's YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss the 7th standard, second topic, that is nutrition in animal. From that, the term digestion in human. How the process of digestion takes place in the human body, today I will explain with the help of this very beautiful diagram. So, as in the part 1 we have discussed, the process of digestion starts from the mouth and ends with the anus. That is, the process of digestion in the human body starts in the buccal cavity and ends with the anus. How does this whole process takes place in the human body? Let's study. Okay, before that, what is the ingestion? Ingestion means what? The process of taking food in the body is called as ingestion. The process of taking food in the body is called as ingestion. Now, by the process of ingestion, human takes place food inside the body, that is in the buccal cavity. You can see clearly, here it is the buccal cavity. In the buccal cavity, there are some organs like tongue and teeth. Whatever the morsel of food we have taken inside the mouth, inside the buccal cavity, that food is chewed properly, and that morsel of food converts into the simpler food. That is, there is the breakdown of the carbohydrates, breakdown of the food particles takes place. During the process of chewing, salivary glands are present here. Near the throat and near the ear, salivary glands are there. These salivary glands secretes saliva, and that saliva mixes into the food. After that, that food converts into the bolus. Bolus means a small circular part which is formed after the chewing and mixing of saliva into the food. That bolus is pulled, that bolus is pushed into the esophagus with the help of tongue. Here is the esophagus. Esophagus is a long muscular organ. Esophagus is a long muscular organ. Now that food goes through this esophagus with the movement of that esophagus. Esophagus is also called as a food pipe. The pipe through which food travels, that is called as a food pipe. It is a esophagus. Now from that esophagus, food goes into the stomach. Stomach is a sac-like part, sac-like muscular part filled with the hydrochloric acid. Here is the presence of hydrochloric acid in that stomach. Now when food enters in the stomach, at that time it is get churned. During the churning, that food becomes acidic due to the presence of hydrochloric acid. Now after here, the process of breakdown of food substances takes place again. The process of this stomach, the process of churning of food takes place in this stomach, and then later that food goes into the small intestine. Here it is the small intestine. Small intestine is a long tube of approximately 7.5 meter long. It is a 7.5 meter long narrow tube is there. Muscular tube is there, and through that tube food passes. When food enters from some stomach to the small intestine, at that time some digestive juices, some glands mixes their digestive juices. Here is the liver. Liver is the largest gland present in the human body. Liver is the largest gland present in the human body, and this liver secretes bile juice. Liver secretes bile juice, B-I-L-E. It is a bile juice. And here it is the pancreas, yellow color part. Pancreas is a yellow color muscular part that secretes pancreatic juice. When food enters from stomach to the intestine, then three digestive juices mixes in that food. First, the bile juice which is secreted by the liver, then pancreatic juice which is secreted by the pancreas, and intestinal juice which is secreted by the intestine itself. Now food goes, passes through this intestine, and in that intestine, the absorption of proteins and fats takes place. Here only the process of digestion, most part of the process of digestion takes place. Whatever that food particles are there, those food particles are get converted into the simpler chemical substances, and those simpler chemical substances are get absorbed into the blood in the small intestine only. Now whatever the remaining food substances, that food substances passes or goes into the large intestine. This is the large intestine, and it is of about 1.5 meter long. In the large intestine, absorption of salt and water takes place, and after the absorption of salts and water, the remaining food passes through this large intestine and stores into the rectum. Rectum is the place where unwanted food material is stored. After that, unwanted food material or undigested food material is expelled throughout the anus. In this way, the process of digestion starts with the buccal cavity and ends with the anus. And these all are the parts of the alimentary canal. These all are the parts of the alimentary canal. Small intestine is the longest part of the alimentary canal, which is of 7.5 meter. In this way, the process of digestion takes place in the human body. For more such videos, please like and subscribe Gurukul English Medium School's YouTube channel, and don't forget to press bell icon. Thank you.